It is one of the great ironies of all time that the Trump presidency has given us more books than ever before. Which is a crazy thing, because this is a guy whose favorite thing to read is the Hooters t-shirt. And this week, another Trump book hits the shelves. This one from former Trump aide and reality TV star Omarosa. And it's safe to say, it's making major headlines.
Omarosa's stunning Meet the Press interview, where she tells all about her time in the White House, what she calls an insider's account of the Trump White House.
They continue to deceive this nation by how mentally declined he is, how difficult it is for him to process complex information. This is a White House where everybody lies. Donald Trump is a con and has been masquerading as someone who is actually open to engaging with diverse communities. He is truly a racist.
Omarosa! How can you say that about the president 3 years after we all said that about the president? How? Seriously, though, Omarosa had to spend a year in the White House to learn that Donald Trump doesn't know what he's doing. Like, I can't wait for her next book, Donald Trump, something's wrong with his hair. But the revelations in Omarosa's book aren't even the juicy part of this story, because it turns out that unlike James Comey, she wasn't just making notes, she was making tapes.
Former presidential advisor Omarosa Manigault Newman admitted that she secretly recorded Chief of Staff John Kelly firing her in the high security White House Situation Room.
Can I ask you a couple of questions? Is the president aware of this?
Don't talk it down the road. This is a non-negotiable discussion.
I don't negotiate. I've never had a chance to talk to you, General Kelly. Yeah, so this is my departure. I'd like to have at least an opportunity to understand.
We can talk another time. This has to do with some pretty serious integrity violations. So I'll let it go with that.
What's weird about this is that Omarosa is presenting these tapes as evidence that she was treated unfairly. But from what she released, John Kelly doesn't sound that bad. If anything, he just sounded like a guy who had a lot more important things to do, you know? He's just like, look, I can't have this conversation right now. The president accidentally swallowed the nuclear launch codes, and we need to come up with some new ones ASAP. Like, if anything, these tapes may have landed Omarosa in hot water, because she took a recording device into the White House Situation Room. That's the room where presidents hold the most classified meetings, like highly classified, things that are too secret for the Oval Office. Like, the Bin Laden raid was run from the Situation Room. I mean, I know now we don't know what they used that room for under Trump. I mean, I bet if we check the security cam footage now, we just see like Ben Carson sneaking in to take naps and Don Jr. going in there to practice his karate, you know? It's just like, the true master is one who can strike without waking me up. And as if taping the chief of staff in the Situation Room wasn't scandalous enough, today, Omarosa dropped her latest mixtape. And this one features the president himself. Oh, and please listen to how Trump reacts when he finds out Omarosa has been fired.
Omarosa, what's going on? I just saw in the news that you're thinking about leaving. What happened?
General Kelly came to me and said that you guys wanted me to leave.
No, nobody even told me about it.
Wow.
You know, they run a big operation, but I didn't know it. I didn't know that.
Yeah.
Damn it. I don't love you leaving at all.
I don't love you leaving at all. I just found out they run a big operation, Omarosa. God damn it. You know, for a man who lies as much as Trump, you think he'd be better at it? He's like, no, I'm so upset about this. I wonder if he did this to people who got fired from The Apprentice, if he also called him, he's like, hey, Gary, I just saw last night's episode. What happened? God damn it, I didn't know. Now, I'll be honest, what we've heard on the tapes is not particularly shocking, but what is shocking is how many people are secretly recording the presidents of the United States all the time. So many people are walking around the White House wearing a wire. I'm surprised that there aren't just feedback loops happening to everyone as they walk, like, people just having conversations like, hey, I was, hey, your recording's interfering with my recording, man. Come on. What frequency are you on? Yeah, just give me your recording after the meeting. This is weird. It's incredible. Everyone has a recording of the president. Omarosa has one. Michael Cohen. Even shock jocks are getting him at this point. Like, there just needs to be a granny category for these at this point. It's just gonna be like, and the award goes to, oh, Adele. Surprise, it's Adele, actually. Now, as usual, when one of Trump's people turns on him, the White House runs its smear campaign playbook, right? They say the person has always been trash. With Omarosa, they've dismissed her as a lying, publicity-hungry reality star who only cares about enriching herself. And when Trump heard that, he was like, are you guys looking at my resume? Are you? For more on this, we turn to our senior political analyst, Ronny Chang, everybody! What have we learned from Omarosa's new book?
Well, I'll tell you what I've learned, Trevor. There is nothing more profitable than working for Donald Trump, okay? Because everyone who gets fired by this guy gets a book deal. I'm waiting for him to fire his chef so we can get a cookbook called 32 Burger Recipes a Fat Liar President Likes. And I'll tell you what else Omarosa has taught me is that I'm doing the right thing because I'm also secretly taping everyone's conversations in this office.
Wait, what? You've been recording people at The Daily Show?
Yeah, that's how you get dirt on everybody so you can write a bestseller after you leave.
Ronnie, I feel like that's such a violation of people's trust.
Yeah, okay, Mr. Ethics. Maybe you'll think differently once you hear what Roy Wood Jr. really says about you.
Hey, Roy, what do you think about Trevor?
Yeah, he's all right. Hey, man, I'm sorry to hear about your grandma.
My grandma?
Yeah, she died, right?
No. I just didn't want to come into work, so I like that she died.
Oh, that's what's up, cool.
You hear that, Trevor? Roy thinks you're just all right. Doesn't sound like a team player to me.
What the hell, Ronnie? I gave you the whole week off, so your grandmother isn't dead?
No, she's alive. Although, the doctors say she's probably gonna die soon. I'm thinking, like, maybe Tuesday after Labor Day, you know, for the weekend.
Ronnie, I'm disappointed in you, man.
Oh, okay, I'm the bad guy. I bet you wish I was more like Desi, huh? You think she's so sweet? Maybe you'll think twice about her when you hear what she says about you.
Hey, Desi, don't you think Trevor has some flaws?
I guess nobody's perfect. Hey, why aren't you Xeroxing a passport?
I'm forging some documents because I'm in the country illegally.
Ha! Suck it, Desi. Now who's America's favorite blonde? Me.
Ronnie, I don't think these tapes are busting who you think they're busting.
Oh, yeah, you would say that, Trevor, but don't forget why I got on you.
Ronnie, are you doing drugs in the office?
My own business.
Hey, what do you think of Trevor Noah?
I'm Trevor Noah.
Yeah, he sucks.
Wow, the great Trevor Noah, hang out with drug users.
Ronnie Chang, everybody. Ronnie Chang. Fuck you. Don't forget to watch a sneak peek of the first episode of Ronnie Chang International Student premiering tonight, right after The Daily Show. Also, the entire series is streaming right now on the Comedy Central app. Ronnie Chang, everybody.